On this glorious day, we're back at our EV installations, and today we're going to look at EVultra cable from Doncaster Cables to see if it can simplify your EV installation.
So if you've been following this series from the start, you'll know we've fitted lots of innovative new products that have been specially designed to help installation of EV chargers. Our first port of call for those products is Replenish, a specialist distributor of the latest kit for EV chargers, and they've got everything, test equipment to cables. And cables is the subject of today's video, Gary. What have we got here?
This cable allows us to have mains, power and data cable all in one, and that's really important.
Yeah, but why would I want to get data out to an EV charger, Gary?
It could be that you need to monitor the power within the installation, which means you need to connect to a current transformer that needs to get its signal out to here.
Okay, but this one here has got, looks like a Cat 5 cable, Gary. Do you want to possibly need to connect to the internet?
Yeah, we know that these chargers now are smart, and the benefits of using smart, which we've looked at in a previous video presentation, in order to get that out, that connectivity, in this case we've got a Cat 5e cable within the actual construction of the EVultra.
Okay, and all chargers are different, so some have wireless connectivity, some can support multiple current transformers, and we think all these options are covered with this EVultra cable. So should we have a closer look at how the cable's made up? We're starting with the armoured version.
Well, you're in first. I would have been in with my hacksaw. Is that a new tool you've got there?
I've had this for years. It did a reasonable job, actually, on small cables.
Well, it must be my turn now because I'm out with the knife. What's beautiful about this is the cable uses a standard steel wire armoured gland, so no specialist glands required for this cable.
No, that's it. So let's just remove the arm and have a look under the inner bedding material. And there we can see our Cat 5 data cable.
And we've also got our conductors in those phase colours. So we've got blue neutral, brown is our line, and green and yellow is our CPC or earth.
Yeah, so no need to oversleeve. And then let's just have a closer look at the data cable. So it's, as you would expect in a data cable, it's got the some shielding. And then there's our four pairs of data cables there.
And what we've got here is we've got the 6mm with the Cat 5e, and it's the armoured version. But they do other versions, don't they?
Yes, they do. So here's a version which is the Tuff sheath with a single pair. Single twisted pair data for, say, current transformer in 6mm. So it also comes in 4mm squared and 6mm squared in all variants.
Okay, with the 2-core and the Cat 5e in it, so that's good. Yeah. And we'll see that in a minute when we look at the data sheets. But what's really nice about cables from Doncaster is they put their name on the side of it, and they're proud to do so. Yeah. And that's manufactured in the UK as well.
So let's just have a quick also look at the variants. So there's our single twisted pair variants in 4 and 6mm, armoured and non-armoured. And the same for the Cat 5e version, non-armoured and armoured with 4 and 6mm conductors. Well, Gary, you've jinxed this video. You started with glorious weather, and the time it's taken us to look at the cable, we've got dark clouds behind us. So before we get rained on, what's the advantages of using this cable?
Well, often the cables are run on the exterior of the building to EV charging points, like it was in this installation, and it means we're only running one cable. You don't want two or three extra cables run on the outside of a building. And we use these clips here from D-Line, these safe D clips, also make it look almost an invisible fixing. So you're trying to limit that for both the customer and making the install easier for the electrician.
Yeah, nobody wants the house to look like a factory at the front, does it? As much as we get proud about how neat we can run cables, one cable is a significant advantage, and especially when it comes to the charger as well, because obviously quite an expensive piece of electronics here, we're worried about IP rating, and with this cable you only need to make one cable entry, which is only one point that you need to maintain the IP rating of, and again, a neater install.
So we've got two versions there of our EVultra cable. We've got the one with the Cat 5e and our single twisted pair. When would we use one over another?
Okay, so single twisted pairs when you're going to connect one current transformer to the EV charger itself. And then when it comes to the Cat 5e, two options. Obviously, everyone's thinking internet connectivity with the Ethernet connection, but a lot of chargers have a wireless connection to a hub, so you don't need that. But this charger here from MyEnergy can support up to three current transformers, and we can use three of the pairs in there to wire to those current transformers. So that's why you'd use that. But then we're probably thinking, what else could we use this cable for, Gary?
Well, you're thinking perhaps, I don't know, garden, office, summer house, at the end of that garden, and you've got the power supply out there and the Wi-Fi is a little bit average, you're thinking hardwired internet connectivity, and this cable's going to provide it for you.
Yeah, I've heard a lot of people are working from home these days, actually. So yeah, you're right, a hardwired connection, better internet connection all round. I'm also thinking some of the more smart light fittings out there sometimes need a data connection for the lighting control system. That's another great application.
We've saved it right to the end. I'm sure people have already commented before they've finished the video. How can we have the Cat5e, which is band one, next to, installed within the same construction of a cable next to the mains, which is band two, Gordon?
Yeah, well, to answer that, we made a separate video that looks at how the regulations treat that scenario. So check out that if you haven't seen it. Some great learning in there. Also, check out the video where we show how this cable is manufactured from raw copper and plastic, and we trace the whole manufacturing process across at Doncaster Cables.
Are you using this cable from Doncaster Cables, the EVultra? Is there something you want to tell us about the cable that we didn't mention in the video? Leave those comments below. Is it a cable now that you didn't know that was out there that you're going to use in the future? Please leave those comments, and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.
Yeah, and now it looks like it's about to rain, Gary. I'm off.
We're off.